Good morning. Thank you for joining us today. My name is Rebecca Yvonne Bayek. I'm a postdoctoral fellow at the Schomburg Center for Research in Black Culture in New York. And I'm presenting here a project I'm working on with Dr. Sinfre Makoni from the Pennsylvania State University. So the title of this presentation is Cultural Meaning of Songo Board Game in Cameroon. So we made it a little bit shorter, but you're going to learn a little bit more about what our research project is all about. So before we start, I think it's really important for us to have an understanding and know what it is. What is Songo board game? So Songo is a non-digital game from Central Africa. It's been played in countries, actually include Cameroon, Gabon, and Equatorial Guinea. So in Cameroon, which is the focus of our research, the gameplay is a true social metaphor of interactions, the community, and the philosophical approach to life. So basic description of Songo, as you can see on the screen there, is a rectangular board, 14 holes, 70 seats, 2 players, and is played in a clockwise direction. Again, all of these are kind of just basic descriptions because the gameplay itself is really a community kind of driven gameplay. So when we think about board games in Africa across the continent, there's a great distribution of this game, and based on our own research, this is what you can find, right? So you find that almost every single country in sub-Saharan Africa. And this is just what we can find. And we believe that there is just more than that, right? So here are a couple of names that when you think about board games on the African continent. So you see countries that you see Benin, Burkina Faso, Cameroon, and you find different names. Cape Verde, Comoros, Democratic Republic of Congo, Equatorial Guinea. So almost all across the continent of Africa, and I think this is a research that's really important to think about these board games and board games that have some kind of similar features but different names and different rules, gameplay rules, and different different design as well. So with that being said, we're going to focus now on the study context. So where are we conducting the study? So we are focusing on Songo that's played in Cameroon. And then Cameroon, basic history, basic background about Cameroon is that the capital city is Yaoundé. The official languages, we have French and English as official languages. Cameroon actually obtained its independence from France on January 1st, 1960. And now the British portion of the country joined the French former territory on 31st of May 1961. So the Cameroon speaks more than 250 languages and as well as many ethnic groups as you can imagine. Originally, the game was played by the Ikang Fang ethnic group, but now the game is played by diverse people, diverse ethnic group from in the kind of the city or urban area of the country. Something that I wanted also to share was the basic rules of the game. Again, we're focusing here on the game played by the Ikang and Fang people, but actually the sub-ethnic group of the Iwondo people, because in Cameroon you can't find actually, when you think about the ethnic groups, so while you say 250 languages, even if you think about it, so we have the Ikang and the Fang, that's a big ethnic group, and then you find among them, you found the Iwondo, you found the Bolo, and the rest of them. So now the game is played 35 seats divided for each player. So you start with 35 seats, you have a total of 70 seats. They often call them seats. And you have 5 seats in each hole or cup. And then each captures are made on the opponent's side of the ball, on the opponent's hole, in the opponent's hole. And then you capture when it's 1, 2, or 3. Any preceding hole contains 2 3 or 4 marbles on the opponent's side is captured as well. The player with 40 seeds wins the game, right? So these are kind of basic rules. They are more complex than that. So now, what is it that we're going to focus on? So one thing that we're seeing in that is that recent research has shown that Sungo board game play actually is a constellation, right, of literacy. So people, players engage in multiple literacies, and this include the literacies that we can just summarize here: embodied cognition, computational thinking, language learning, mathematical skills, strategic thinking, collaboration. So the current research that we're going to focus on is what? Is that this current research poses the question of the role of board games, and particularly Sungo board game, in developing community identity, social cohesion, and cross-cultural communication. What we know is that recent archaeological research on board games shows that these games can facilitate interaction, especially across cultural borders and different societies. However, the contemporary evidence to support this idea remain largely anecdotal and overall lacking kind of, you know, evidence. So this is why we decided, okay, you know what, why don't we look at what, you know, Sungo board game does, right? So how does it build community identity, social cohesion, or cross-cultural communication within the country of Cameroon, especially in the urban area, the urban setting, which is Yaoundé, where we find out, you know, we have multiple ethnic groups, but again, we find out that today, many diverse groups are playing a game that is originally for the Akan and the Fang people. So now, the research questions that we have, I just want to mention here that we have sub research questions for each main research question, but we're just going to focus here on the main research question. So first question is that, how does player identity affect participation in Sungo gameplay? And we think about identity meaning that the ethnic identity, right? Who are they, right? So for example, how do players relate to each other and the Sungo gaming community? And the other question that we have is that, what do players learn through the game? So those are the main questions that we have. And so the research method that we are adopting in this case is that we're using a combination of ethnographic techniques such as observation, interviews, and video recordings, as well as multiple case study techniques, because we're going to focus on multiple gaming groups, right? Gaming groups in the city. So it's not just on one gaming group, but multiple gaming groups, and then to address the research questions that we have. So those are kind of this is the way we're going to approach the study. And for now, we are presenting it to let you know what is that we're thinking about, we're thinking of doing. And one thing that has happened, we were a bit delayed because of the pandemic and countries shutting down, not allowing people to be, keeping the distance, social distancing. So this is one of the challenges, which means that actually even in the country, the game is not that as played. Doing such research is a bit challenging, but we're looking forward to actually conducting the study. So this is what we're gonna focus on, and this is kind of a brief presentation of what our study is about. And we hope that you got to understand or to have a general idea of what we're talking about. So with that being said, we want to say thank you, and we are looking forward to your questions. And thank you again for just being here with us and watching our video. Thank you so much, and talk to you in a couple of minutes.